Okay, we're going to talk about surface area and volume of cylinders. So in our previous lesson, we talked about finding volume, which is just simply getting the base area, which is the area of the circle, and times the height. Okay, in this example, the height that I've given you is 10, and we need to figure out this base area. And so at the base area, the area of the circle here, is pi r squared, and we know that the radius is 6, so it's going to be pi times 6 squared, which is going to give me 36 pi, and if I'm going to round it with a decimal, I'm going to say, okay, I've got 36 times pi, and then I get 113, okay? So 113. Meters squared. So now I'm going to say, okay, so I've got my volume is equal to 113 meters squared times my height, which is 10 meters. And so then my volume is going to be equal to 1,130 meters cubed. Okay, and whenever you're doing volumes, your units are going to be cubed. Now let's talk about surface area. So in order to find the surface area of this, we're going to also need to use circumference. Now circumference is the length around the circle. So if I had a can and I took top of the can, then I would have a circle, right? And then I've got the side of the can, and then I would have another circle. Okay, and so the area of this circle now, I only have R and I only have H right now. So this area is equal to pi R squared. And same thing with this area. Okay. Now, how do I figure out what is the length around the circle? So the length around the circle is going to be the length of this rectangle. And the height of this rectangle is going to be the height of my of my cylinder. So the thing that you need to remember is that circumference is equal to 2 pi r. Okay, and we're going to be, this is important because that's going to be the length of this right here. So this length right from here to here is 2 pi r. That's this length right here. And we've got this height is this length here. So the area of this rectangle is equal to 2 pi r times the height h. Okay, so the total surface area, I'm going to use SA for surface area, is going to be it's going to be pi r squared plus pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. Okay, this is the rectangle, these are the two circles. Since these are the same, let's add them together, and my surface area formula is going to be 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. And that is our surface area formula. And we're going to be using this to calculate surface area, which is the sides of the can plus the top and the bottom. If you need help on this, watch the video again and or ask me help during office hours. You might want to hit pause and replay to listen to this again. So let's look. We got two examples we're going to do. Okay, so let's find the surface area of this. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draw my picture. And I've got the circle on the top and the circle on the bottom. And my top here, this area is going to be pi r squared, but the r is 6, so we've got 6 squared. And this area equals pi 6 squared. Okay. Now, this length here, remember that the circumference is equal to 2 pi r, and the radius is 6. So this length here is going to be 2 pi times 6, and this height we know is 10. So this area here for the rectangle is equal to 2 times pi times 6 times 10. Okay, let's just simplify that. Okay, so the area of the rectangle is, okay, so 2 times 6 is 12, and 12 times 10 is 120. So we have 120 pi. All right, so we're going to use these pieces of information to solve for our surface area. So let's do this. So the surface area is, so pi times 6 squared is going to give me 36 pi plus 36 pi plus 120 pi. So this is the top circle. This is the bottom circle. And this is the area of the rectangle. Okay. Top circle, bottom circle, area of the rectangle. So we add these all together and we get our surface area. So 36 plus 36 is 72 plus 120 and that gives us 192. So we end up with 192 pi. Now, what if you want a decimal answer? Then I would multiply this 192 times pi, and then I would get 603.2. So this is approximately equal to, what did I say, 603.2 meters squared. Okay, now remember that area has units squared and volume has units cubed. So this is very important to remember. Okay. Okay. Don't forget that area has units squared and volume has units cubed. And that is it for these notes.